हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू प्रशांत आईएएस। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स एंड फ्रॉम दिस क्लास वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर डिस्कशन फर्दर। सो फ्रेंड्स, देयर आर थ्री कैटेगरी ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स। ओके, सो देयर आर थ्री कैटेगरी ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स। द फर्स्ट कैटेगरी इज कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स, सेकेंड कैटेगरी इज मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट एंड द थर्ड कैटेगरी इज डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स। सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर, मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट एंड डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स एंड व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द थ्री। सो इन दिस क्लास वी विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द आंसर टू दीज क्वेश्चंस। सो फ्रेंड्स, कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर द सीनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स। ओके, सो कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर द सीनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स मींस दे आर रैंक वन मिनिस्टर्स। दे आर रैंक वन मिनिस्टर्स मींस दे आर मोस्ट पावरफुल एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट मिनिस्टर्स। सो यू कैन से दैट कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर सीनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स। दे आर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट मिनिस्टर्स, मोर ओवर दे आर मोस्ट पावरफुल मिनिस्टर्स। एंड इफ वी हैव टू समराइज दिस ऑल, देन वी कैन से दैट कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर रैंक वन मिनिस्टर्स। सो फ्रेंड्स, वेन एवर अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर इज गिवन अ चार्ज ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री, वेन एवर अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर इज गिवन अ चार्ज ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री देन ही इज गिवन द फुल चार्ज ऑफ दैट मिनिस्ट्री, मीन्स ही इज मेड द हेड ऑफ दैट मिनिस्ट्री। सो वेन एवर अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर इज गिवन द चार्ज ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री देन ही ऑलवेज बिकम्स द हेड ऑफ दैट मिनिस्ट्री। फॉर एग्जाम्पल फ्रेंड्स, श्री अमित शाह। ओके, सो अमित शाह इज अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर, दैट्स वाई ही इज ऑल्सो द हेड ऑफ होम मिनिस्ट्री। ओके, सो अमित शाह इज अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर एंड ही इज द हेड ऑफ होम मिनिस्ट्री। सिमिलरली वी कैन से दैट श्री राजनाथ सिंह, श्री राजनाथ सिंह इज ऑल्सो अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर, सो ही इज द हेड ऑफ डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री। ओके, सो श्री राजनाथ सिंह इज द कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर, ही इज अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर, सो ही इज द हेड ऑफ डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री। सिमिलरली श्री नितिन जयराम गडकरी इज ऑल्सो अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर, दैट्स वाई ही इज द हेड ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रोड ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड हाईवेज। सिमिलरली फ्रेंड्स, श्रीमती निर्मला सीतारमन इज ऑल्सो अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर, दैट्स वाई सी इज द हेड ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस। मोर ओवर सी इज ऑल्सो द हेड ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉरपोरेट अफेयर्स। सिमिलरली फ्रेंड्स, श्री रामविलास पासवान इज ऑल्सो अ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर, दैट्स वाई ही इज द हेड ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कंज्यूमर अफेयर्स फूड एंड पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। ओके, सो इन शॉर्ट वी कैन से दैट कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर रैंक वन मिनिस्टर्स, दे आर मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट मिनिस्टर्स, दे आर मोस्ट पावरफुल मिनिस्टर्स एंड वेन एवर दे आर गिवन अ चार्ज ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री, वेन एवर दे आर गिवन अ चार्ज ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री देन दे ऑलवेज बिकम्स द हेड ऑफ दैट मिनिस्ट्री, मीन्स दे आर गिवन द फुल चार्ज ऑफ दैट मिनिस्ट्री, दे ऑलवेज बिकम्स द हेड ऑफ दैट मिनिस्ट्री। Now friends, these cabinet ministers have the right to attend cabinet meeting. Okay, so cabinet ministers have the right to attend cabinet meeting. So it is their right. Okay, it is their right to attend cabinet meetings. Now what is the meaning of cabinet meeting? So this I will tell you later on in this lecture. Okay, but for the time being, you just remember that cabinet ministers has the right to attend cabinet meeting. Nobody can stop them from attending cabinet meetings. Now friends, let's move further to minister of state. Now friends, ministers of state are second rank ministers. Okay, so as I have told you that cabinet ministers are rank one ministers, similarly friends, minister of states are second rank ministers. Now what does it mean? So it means that their post is less important to the cabinet ministers, their post is less important than the cabinet ministers. Moreover they are less powerful than the cabinet ministers. Okay, so minister of states is the second rank ministers, minister of state are the second rank ministers, means देयर पोस्ट इज नॉट एज पावरफुल एज कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स, देयर पोस्ट इज लेस पावरफुल एज कंपेयर टू द पोस्ट ऑफ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स, देयर पोस्ट इज लेस इंपॉर्टेंट एज कंपेयर टू द पोस्ट ऑफ कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स. ओके, सो इन शॉर्ट वी कैन से दैट मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ स्टेट आर सेकेंड रैंक मिनिस्टर. ओके, सो कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर फर्स्ट रैंक मिनिस्टर्स एंड मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट्स आर सेकेंड रैंक मिनिस्टर्स. नाउ फ्रेंड्स, एज दे आर सेकेंड रैंक मिनिस्टर्स, सो वट इज देयर मेन वर्क? सो दे आर नॉट गिवन द चार्ज ऑफ फुल मिनिस्ट्री. ओके, दे आर नॉट गिवन द चार्ज ऑफ फुल मिनिस्ट्री मीन्स दे आर नॉट मेड द हेड ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री. दे आर नॉट मेड द हेड ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री, दे आर नॉट गिवन द फुल चार्ज ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री. सो वट इज देयर मेन वर्क? देयर मेन वर्क इज टू असिस्ट द कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स. देयर मेन वर्क is to help the cabinet ministers. Okay, so what is their main work? Their main work is to assist the cabinet ministers, help the cabinet ministers. Okay, so generally what happens that minister of states are not given full charge of any ministry, means they are not made the head of any ministry, and their main work is to assist the cabinet ministers. Their main work is to help the cabinet ministers. But friends, the prime minister of the country, okay, Prime Minister of the country has the power to give independent charge, to give the charge of full ministry to any minister of state. Okay, so Prime Minister in his own discretion, Prime Minister in his own discretion can make any minister of state as the head of any ministry. Okay friends, so Prime Minister in his discretion can make any minister of state as the head of any ministry, and then they will be called as minister of state with independent charge. Okay, then what they will be called? Then they will be called as minister of state with independent charge. So friends, whenever prime minister of the country makes any minister of state as the head of any ministry, okay, or whenever prime minister of the country gives the charge of full ministry to any minister of state, then he is called as minister of state with independent charge. Minister of state with independent charge. For example friends, Sri G. Kishan Reddy is deployed in Ministry of Home Affairs. So he is a minister of state. Okay, and he is deployed in Ministry of Home Affairs means his main work is to help Amit Shah in his work. His main work is to help Home Ministry in his work. Okay, so Sri G. Kishan Reddy is deployed in Ministry of Home Affairs. So he is not the head of Ministry of Home Affairs. Okay, he works under the control and leadership of Mr. Amit Shah, who is the head of Ministry of Home Affairs. Similarly, friends, there are many minister of states who are having independent charge in India. There are many minister of states who are having independent charge in India. For example, Shri Prahlad Singh Patel. Okay, so Shri Prahlad Singh Patel is a minister of state with independent charge, and he is the in charge of Ministry of Culture and Ministry of Tourism. Okay, so there are many ministers who are also the head of many ministries. There are many minister of states who are having independent charge. Okay, and in short we can say that there are many ministers of state with independent charge. So for example friends, Shri Rajkumar Singh is also a minister of state with independent charge. So he is the in charge of Ministry of Power and Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So this was the meaning of minister of states. Now friends, minister of states do not enjoy the right to attend cabinet meeting. Okay, so minister of states do not enjoy the right to attend cabinet meeting, and they can only attend cabinet meeting when they get invitation, means when they are called to attend the meeting. So minister of states do not have the right to attend cabinet meeting. They can only attend the cabinet meeting when they get invitation to attend the cabinet meeting. Now friends, let's move to deputy ministers. So what is the meaning of deputy ministers? So friends, deputy ministers are the थर्ड रैंक मिनिस्टर्स. ओके, सो वी कैन से दैट डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर द थर्ड रैंक मिनिस्टर्स और दे आर जूनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स. ओके, सो डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर द जूनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स, मीन्स दे आर लेस पावरफुल देन मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट एंड कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर. देयर पोस्ट इज लेस इंपॉर्टेंट देन द पोस्ट ऑफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट एंड कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स. ओके, सो वी कैन से दैट दे आर थर्ड रैंक मिनिस्टर एंड जूनियर मिनिस्टर. ओके, सो डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर द जूनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स. नाउ फ्रेंड्स, डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर नेवर गिवन द चार्ज ऑफ फुल मिनिस्ट्री. ओके, सो डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर नेवर मेड द हेड ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री. सो डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर द जूनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स, सो दे आर नेवर मेड द हेड ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री. सो वट इज देयर मेन वर्क? देयर मेन वर्क इज टू असिस्ट, देयर मेन वर्क इज टू हेल्प कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स, मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट एंड मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट विथ इंडिपेंडेंट चार्ज इन देयर वर्क. ओके, सो डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर द मिनिस्टर्स हु आर द जूनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स, दे आर थर्ड रैंक मिनिस्टर्स एंड देयर मेन वर्क इज टू असिस्ट मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट, मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट इंडिपेंडेंट चार्ज एंड कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स इन देयर वर्क. सो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ लेट्स समराइज व्हाट वी हैव लर्न्ड सो फार. सो फ्रेंड्स, कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर रैंक वन मिनिस्टर, सो देयर रैंक इज वन. मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट्स आर रैंक टू मिनिस्टर्स एंड डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर रैंक थ्री मिनिस्टर्स. मीन्स कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर मोस्ट पावरफुल मिनिस्टर्स. ओके, कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर मोस्ट पावरफुल एंड सीनियर मोस्ट मिनिस्टर्स, वेयर एज मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट्स आर लेस पावरफुल देन कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स. एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड, डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर इवन लेस पावरफुल देन मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट्स. सो कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर रैंक वन मिनिस्टर, मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट आर रैंक टू मिनिस्टर एंड डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर रैंक थ्री मिनिस्टर. कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स आर मोस्ट पावरफुल, मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एंड सीनियर मोस्ट, वेयर एज मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट्स आर लेस पावरफुल देन कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स एंड डेप्यूटी मिनिस्टर्स आर इवन लेस पावरफुल देन मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट्स. देन फ्रेंड्स, कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स हैज द राइट टू अटेंड कैबिनेट मीटिंग. ओके, कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स हैज द राइट टू अटेंड कैबिनेट मीटिंग्स, बट मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट्स कैन ओनली अटेंड कैबिनेट मीटिंग व्हेन दे गेट इनविटेशन. सो दे कैन ओनली अटेंड कैबिनेट मीटिंग व्हेन दे गेट इनविटेशन. विदाउट इनविटेशन दे कैन नॉट अटेंड कैबिनेट मीटिंग. देन फ्रेंड्स, द मेन वर्क ऑफ अ मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट इज टू हेल्प, इज टू असिस्ट द कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर. ओके, सो द मेन वर्क ऑफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट इज टू हेल्प एंड असिस्ट द कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर. बट प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज द पावर टू गिव द चार्ज ऑफ फुल मिनिस्ट्री, मीन्स टू मेक द हेड ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री. सो प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज द पावर टू मेक एनी मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट एज द हेड ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री. एंड व्हेन अ मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट इज मेड द हेड ऑफ एनी मिनिस्ट्री, देन ही विल बी कॉल्ड एज मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट विथ इंडिपेंडेंट चार्ज. Minister of State with independent charge. Now friends, deputy ministers are never made the head of any ministry. Okay, so they are never made the head of any ministry and their main work is to help. Their main work is to assist the cabinet ministers as well as minister of state as well as minister of state with independent charge. So friends, now I hope that you are very clear with, you must be very clear with the meaning of cabinet ministers, minister of state and deputy ministers. Now friends, let's move further. So then friends, the question arises that who are parliamentary secretaries? Okay, what is the meaning of parliamentary secretary? So friends, here on the screen, I am drawing a diagram. Okay, and this diagram, this rectangle represents parliament. Okay, so what is this rectangle? This rectangle is parliament. Now friends, these all cross in the blue color represents the member of parliament. Okay, so they all are the member of parliament. So these all cross in the blue color, they all represents member of parliament. So member of parliament means member of Lok Sabha plus the member of Rajya Sabha. Now friends, let's suppose that these all the cross in the green circle, okay, all the cross in the green circle, they are the members of ruling party. Ruling party means the party who is having majority in Lok Sabha, the party who has formed the government. So this ऑल द स्टार्स इन द ग्रीन सर्कल, ऑल द स्टार्स इन द ग्रीन सर्कल दे आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ रूलिंग पार्टी, दे आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ रूलिंग पार्टी. एंड आउट ऑफ दीज मेंबर्स ऑफ रूलिंग पार्टी लेट सपोज दैट दिस सर्कल, ओके दिस सर्कल रिप्रेजेंट्स यूनियन काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स, ओके सो दिस रेड सर्कल रिप्रेजेंट्स यूनियन काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स, सो दे आर काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स. नाउ फ्रेंड्स हु आर पार्लियामेंट्री सेक्रेटरी, सो फ्रेंड्स पार्लियामेंट्री सेक्रेटरी, सो नाउ लेट सपोज दैट दीज ऑल पर्सन्स, ओके दीज ऑल पर्सन्स इन दिस ऑरेंज सर्कल, दीज ऑल मेंबर्स इन दिस ऑरेंज सर्कल दे ऑल आर पार्लियामेंट्री सेक्रेटरी. सो हु आर पार्लियामेंट्री सेक्रेटरी, सो फ्रेंड्स बेसिकली पार्लियामेंट्री सेक्रेटरी आर द मेंबर ऑफ रूलिंग पार्टी, ओके पार्लियामेंट्री, एज यू कैन सी दैट दिस ऑरेंज सर्कल इज विद इन द ग्रीन सर्कल एंड ग्रीन सर्कल रिप्रेजेंट्स रूलिंग पार्टी. सो पार्लियामेंट्री सेक्रेटरी आर बेसिकली द मेंबर्स ऑफ रूलिंग पार्टी. नाउ फ्रेंड्स दीज पार्लियामेंट्री सेक्रेटरीज आर अपॉइंटेड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर, ओके दीज पार्लियामेंट्री सेक्रेटरीज आर अपॉइंटेड बाय Prime Minister. So Prime Minister has the power to appoint these parliamentary secretaries. Now what is their work? Okay, so their main work is to help the members of COM. So this red circle will represent COM and this orange circle represent parliamentary secretary. So the main work of parliamentary secretary is to assist the members of COM in parliament. Okay, so the main work of these parliamentary secretaries is to assist the members of Council of Ministers in the parliament. Now friends, here one thing you need to remember that parliamentary secretaries are not the members of COM. Okay, so they are not the members of COM, means parliamentary secretary are not ministers. They are the members of ruling party who are appointed by the prime minister, and their main work is to help and assist the members of COM, means to help and assist the ministers in parliament, okay, in legislations in parliament. So their main work is to help and to assist the members of COM in parliament. Now friends, the oath of the office is conducted by Prime Minister. Okay, the oath of the office of Parliamentary Secretary is conducted by the Prime Minister. Now one thing you need to remember that the post of Parliamentary Secretary, okay, this post is not mentioned in the Constitution of India. The post of Parliamentary Secretary is not mentioned in the Constitution of India. And friends, Many state high courts have declared the post of parliamentary secretary as unconstitutional. So this is not mentioned in the constitution, and many state high courts have declared it unconstitutional. And it is currently in news also, okay, because currently Karnataka High Court declared Parliamentary Secretaries Act as unconstitutional. Okay, so this is in news because the Karnataka High Court declared the Parliamentary Secretary Act of the state, okay, Parliamentary Secretaries Act of the Karnataka state as unconstitutional. So now your assignment is to go and to read about this news, okay, so you have to Google this news and you have to read about this news. Now friends, let's move further. So friends, now let us discuss about the cabinet, okay. Now what is cabinet? So friends, here on the screen, again I am drawing a diagram, okay. So here on the screen, again I am drawing a diagram. So now this is the diagram of Council of Ministers, okay. Now this is the diagram of Council of Ministers, COM, Council of Ministers. Now friends, Council of Ministers is a big body, means there are many members in the Council of Ministers, okay. So there are many members in the Council of Ministers. So friends, all these blue stars in this black rectangle represents members of Council of Ministers. So they all are members of Council of Ministers, or in short we can say that they are ministers, okay. So they all are member of Council of Ministers, or in short we can say that they all are ministers. Now friends, as I have told you that basically there are three category of ministers: cabinet ministers plus minister of state plus deputy ministers, okay. So this body Council of Minister is consisting of these three type of ministers. Okay, so in this blue circle, in this rectangle, these blue stars represent cabinet ministers as well as minister of state, as well as minister of state independent charge, as well as deputy ministers. So council of ministers is a very big body, and there are many ministers in the council of ministers. Why? Because cabinet ministers, minister of state, minister of state independent charge, and deputy ministers all are the part of council of ministers. Okay, now friends, we all know that all the administrative decisions, okay, all the administrative decisions are taken by council of ministers. Okay, so all the administrative decisions are taken by council of ministers. Moreover, all the legislations, means all the laws, are proposed in parliament. All the bills are proposed in parliament by council of ministers. So first of all the decisions are taken by council of ministers, then all the bills in the parliament are proposed by council of ministers. Moreover friends, all the policies for the country are made by the council of ministers. Now friends, let's suppose that if there are 70 members in council of ministers, okay, just suppose, okay, so here we are taking a hypothetical number. So just suppose if there are 70 members in the council of ministers, okay, then is it possible that all these 70 members can have healthy discussion? Okay, so is it possible that can these all members, okay, is it possible to have a healthy discussion? Is it possible to have a healthy debate in 70 members? So friends, 70 members is a big number. And when there are more number of people, then it is practically not possible to have a good debate. It is practically not possible to have a good discussion. And without good discussion and good debate, it is not possible to take good decisions. Okay, why? Because there are many members. So what some members can do? Some members can ignore the discussion. Okay, some member can be busy in gossiping. Okay, so council of ministers is a very big body. There are many members in council of ministers. So if all of the members of council of ministers, means all the ministers are included in the discussion. If all the ministers are included in the debate, then it will be practically impossible to take good decision for the country. It will be practically impossible to take quick and good decision for the country. Okay, why? Because if there are more number of people, then what some people will do? Some people will just ignore the debate. Okay, what some people will do? Some people will sleep. Okay, you know this happens. Okay, moreover, what some people can do? Some people can be busy in gossiping. So there can be means if the number of people is more, then a healthy debate and good decision making is not possible. That's why friend, there is a small body within this council of ministers, and this body is known as cabinet. Okay, so this body in red color is known as cabinet. And who are the member of this cabinet? So I have told you about cabinet ministers. So all the cabinet ministers means all the rank one ministers. So all the cabinet ministers are the part of this body called as cabinet. Okay, so friends, all the cabinet ministers are the part of this body called as cabinet. So friends, and the meeting of these all cabinet ministers, the meeting of this body cabinet is called as cabinet meeting. Okay, so the meeting of this body cabinet is called as cabinet meeting. Now friends, this body cabinet meets regularly. Okay, so it is the duty of this body cabinet to meet regularly. And after meeting these all ministers, okay, so after meeting, this body cabinet takes decision for the country. This body cabinet decides that which bills are to be introduced in parliament. Moreover, all the important policies for the country are made by cabinet. And friends, the collective decision making of the cabinet. Collective decision making means decision of all the members of cabinet. means the decision of all the cabinet ministers. So the collective decision making of the cabinet is considered as the collective decision making of council of ministers. Now what does it mean? So it means that suppose if a decision is taken by cabinet, okay, if a decision is taken by cabinet, then it will be considered as the decision of entire council of ministers. If a policy is made by cabinet, then that policy is considered to be made by entire council of ministers. If a bill is introduced in Lok Sabha by council of, by cabinet, then that bill is considered to be introduced in Lok Sabha by council of ministers. Okay, so in short, we can say that all the decisions of council of ministers, all the decisions of council of ministers are practically taken by cabinet. Why? Because the number of members in cabinet are less. Moreover, the members in cabinet are cabinet ministers. So they are rank one ministers. They are senior most ministers. Okay. And they are most important and most powerful ministers. So they all are very good persons. Okay. So we can say that the body cabinet takes all the decisions on behalf of council of ministers. Now friends, this body cabinet is headed by the prime minister. Okay, so prime minister is the head of cabinet, or we can say that prime minister is the leader of cabinet. Okay, so if we have to summarize, then we can say that cabinet is a body within council of ministers. Okay, and who are the members of cabinet? So all the cabinet ministers, means all the rank one ministers, are the member of cabinet. And who is the head of cabinet? So prime minister is the head of cabinet. Okay, then we can say that all the decisions of the country, all the decisions are taken by the cabinet. All the policies are made by the cabinet. And the decision taken by cabinet is considered as the decision taken by council of ministers. Means once a decision is taken by the cabinet, then it is considered that all the members of council of ministers has taken that decision. Okay, so once if a decision is taken by cabinet, then it is considered that all the members of council of minister has taken that decision. So the collective decision making of cabinet automatically becomes the collective decision making of COM. Okay, so if a decision is taken by cabinet, then it is considered that actually that decision is taken by council of ministers. Now friends, originally, the word cabinet was not given in the constitution. Okay, so the word cabinet was not given in the constitution of India. So we have adopted the cabinet from the parliament of Britain. Okay, so we have adopted it from the parliamentary proceedings of Britain. So originally, cabinet word was not given in the constitution of India. We have adopted it from the parliamentary proceedings. We have adopted it from the Britain. Now friends, then what happened? That then came 44th Constitutional Amendment Act 1978. So then came 44th Constitutional Amendment Act 1978. And what this Amendment Act did? That this Amendment Act actually amended Article 352 of the Indian Constitution. So 44th Constitutional Amendment Act 1978 amended the Article 352 of Indian Constitution, and it added the word cabinet. Okay, it introduced the word cabinet in Article 352 of the Indian Constitution. Okay, so friends, after 44th Constitutional Amendment Act, word cabinet means cabinet got the constitutional recognition. So now cabinet is constitutional, but before 44th Constitutional Amendment Act, it was not constitutional. It was established under conventions of Britain. It was established under conventions of England. Okay, but after 44th Constitutional Amendment Act, cabinet got the constitutional recognition. Now friends, this cabinet is assisted by a office called as cabinet secretariat. Okay, so this cabinet is assisted by a office called as cabinet secretariat, and the head of this cabinet secretariat, means the boss of this cabinet secretariat, is a cabinet secretary. Okay, the head of this office cabinet secretariat is cabinet secretary, एंड फ्रेंड्स द कैबिनेट सेक्रेटरी इज द सीनियर मोस्ट सिविल सर्वेंट ऑफ द कंट्री. ओके सो दिस पर्सन कैबिनेट सेक्रेटरी इज द सीनियर मोस्ट सिविल सर्वेंट ऑफ द कंट्री. सो जनरली ही इज द सीनियर मोस्ट IAS ऑफिसर. ओके सो ही इज द सीनियर मोस्ट सिविल सर्वेंट और वी कैन से दैट जनरली ही इज अ सीनियर मोस्ट IAS ऑफिसर. सो वेन यू पीपल विल बिकम IAS ऑफिसर एंड वेन you were and when you will get many promotions, so after many promotions you may also get a chance to become cabinet secretariat. Okay, so means when you will become the senior most IAS officer of the country, then you can also become cabinet secretary. Okay, so friends, cabinet secretariat is the office, cabinet secretariat is the office to assist the cabinet. Okay, to help the cabinet, and cabinet secretary is the head, is the boss of that office. And who is cabinet secretary? So he is the senior most. Okay, he is the senior most IAS officer, he is the senior most civil servant of the country. So friends, that's all for today. Friends, today's class is little short because I have some very urgent work. Okay, so we will now continue our discussion in the next class. So friends, I hope that you all must have enjoyed the lecture. So if you have enjoyed the lecture, so please like the video, comment, share the video and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon and select all. And share this channel to at least 10 people who are preparing for UPSC. Friends, I have uploaded the link of notes in the description of the video and you can also directly download the notes from my blog. Till then, take care of yourself. Thank you.